Latest news. Bandit informants have exposed some politicians funding them. Governor Matawal opens up. You're welcome to this news. The news details. Please listen to the end. Bello Matawal, the governor of Zamfara State, has said that politicians sabotaged the amnesty program he instituted for bandits in the state. Matawal disclosed this on the Urgent Conversations program hosted by Radio Now 95.3 FM on Friday. The governor stated that politicians who had connections with the bandits told them not to believe what the government was saying. He said, after we initiated the dialogue, you know it was supposed to be a collective effort between the government, the people of the state, and other political gladiators. Unfortunately, while the government was trying to make sure we had peace, some political highlights were thinking they did not want us to succeed. So, they were making so many negative comments about the dialogue and the reconciliation. And some of them who had connections with the criminals told them all sorts of things so that they would not believe the government's amnesty and reconciliation. Meanwhile, who was among those who called for dialogue with the bandits terrorizing the northwestern region of Nigeria? At once told the News Agency of Nigeria in August that the program had yielded results in the state. He, however, changed his stance in September when he announced that his administration would no longer grant amnesty to the bandits since they refused the peaceful gesture extended to them. The governor revealed that security agencies had confessions from 2,000 informants who had indicted several politicians. We have some records. Some of the informants that were arrested. We have over 2,000 informants in the custody of security agencies. And some of them have opened up and indicted so many people. They said some of the politicians were the one funding them, telling them the state and federal government were not serious on what we promised to them, the governor said. The politicians who are funding these bandits have been exposed, but their names were not mentioned. Why are their names not mentioned? Why are we just hearing? We know the politicians that are sponsoring bandits. We know the politicians that are sponsoring IPOB. But these people are not mentioning the names of those politicians. All what they are saying is, it is one person from the National House of Assembly, it is one politician from this place. Why? Matawal, the governor of Zamfara State, has said that the politicians have made it clear to the bandits that the government have nothing for them. The government did not have anything for them, so they are making them to believe That is why they are going ahead and carrying out their bandit work. And it is these politicians that will still come up tomorrow and tell the great people of Nigeria that bandits will soon come to an end in Nigeria. Yet, they are the one sponsoring these bandits, paying them to carry out all these killings, insurgents in Nigeria. They are making them to believe that the federal government has nothing for them, has nothing for their life, so they should continue destroying the country in Nigeria. The politicians should make amendment on this. They are not with us, but yet they are sending the child of another person to cause insurgents in the country in Nigeria. Recall that Lai Muhammad also said they know those politicians sponsoring bandits, sponsoring hip-hop. Yet the name of the so-called politician was not mentioned. A lot of politicians are financing these bandits, because if they are not financing them, how are they getting their ammunitions, their arms, food? Because they are staying in bushes, so there's no way they can be getting all this if there is no sponsor underneath. And they're saying that one politician from the National House of Assembly is part of those sponsoring bandits in Nigeria. Some of the bandits are not even in the country Nigeria. Some ammunitions are sent from outside the country to these bandits to carry out their atrocities in some particular states. Now look at what is happening in the northeast. The Boko Haram, the Fulani herdsmen, doing all sorts of things, killing, destroying lives, and shedding blood. Look at the southeast, burning of properties. Unknown gunmen today, unknown gunmen tomorrow. The politicians have to stop this. They are endangering the lives of their fellow citizens. And after they will come on board, that they should vote for them, after endangering the lives of those people. Thank you for tuning in. Please feel free to share your view on this.